The cost of an average used car has now surpassed $25,000. Ladies and gentlemen, hey everybody, my name is JJ. You're watching Bolt, Boom, Bear, Bust. It's May 11th, 2021. Thank you for joining me for this update. Please do me a quick favor. Make sure that you are subscribed and that you have the notification bell turned on so you get these updates. Got another very important update on these rising prices, the inflation situation here in the United States. Let's first talk about the used car prices, and we're going to talk about some other information in addition to the used car situation. $25,000 for the typical used car. We've got the chip shortage. We've got surging demand with all the stimulus and economic boost being put into the economic system here in the United States. And cars are getting scooped up very, very quickly. This is out of Fox11Online.com. A car dealer says the following, quote, "We usually keep 60 to 70 cars in our lot. Now we're lucky if we have 30 to 35 right now." That's Jacob McLean, assistant manager of Greenville Auto. He goes on to say, used cars are leaving the lot within hours of arriving, and there's a thinning supply of new vehicles also. The primary reason is the global semiconductor chip shortage, which hampers the auto industry's ability to manufacture new vehicles. So less new vehicles for sale, causing lower supply, rising prices, pushing more people to buy a used vehicle. So the new vehicle market's impacting the used vehicle market. Now $25,000, actually well over that, $25,463 is now the average used car price. From this Fox 11 article, to put this into perspective, the manager at the car dealer there says that a 2013 base level Toyota Sienna sold last year for $14,000 is now going for about $18,000 here in 2021. Now let's talk about the global chip shortage, and it's not just impacting the United States. This is a CNBC article right here. Right, so maybe this will incentivize U.S. companies to start making chips. But currently, and this article says it right here, the vast majority of the world's chips are made in China. But the U.S. is actually the world's second biggest producer of these chips. But it's not just in vehicles, but even appliances. Now, something that really surprised me, the average cost now of the used car, $25,463, that's $2,800 more than the price paid just 1 year ago, the same month last year, $2,800 more in just 1 year. So if you're someone sitting back trying to save up to buy a used car, you probably lost ground unless you saved up a lot of money, because just waiting a year, you're paying almost $3,000 more for the typical used car. How high can prices go? How much longer can this go on? Nobody really knows, but we need to continue to prepare. Also, sales skyrocketing. Used car sales hit 3.4 million in April. That's up 58% from a year ago. That's out of True Car. And we're seeing big slowdowns in production from General Motors and Ford both. And autoblog.com has the following to say, this is not going away anytime soon. So get ready for even higher prices. Now combine that with the higher gas prices. We see what they're saying is the attack, the cyber attack, causing the pipeline that goes from Texas to New Jersey to shut down. Expect more quote unquote surprises. Just wait until the monetary system gets quote unquote cyber attack happens there, and that gets shut down and the banks go dark. You're going to see within 24 hours, you'll see massive, massive chaos. Why? Because so many people have to swipe their card just to be able to survive. Once the grid goes down, even the monetary system, just temporarily for a few days, is all it takes. You're going to see a big uptick in crime, desperate people, millions of starving people in an instant. So get ready, because things are going to get a lot crazier here in 2021, in my opinion. Now, I'm not saying these real shocking events are going to happen tomorrow, next week, or next month, but get ready, because 2021 is going to be a wild, wild ride. And remember, looking back just a year or two ago, before all these recent events happened with the Great Sickness and all this economic calamity unfolding here, people said, you know, the things I said were never going to happen. We're starting to see now a lot of things, what we've been talking about, rising prices, higher inflation, permanent stimulus checks now being discussed, what people, some people would call universal basic income. It's now coming very, very close to that. And more calls are out there from lawmakers to make these checks come out every month. And what's going to happen is they're going to point to these rising prices from the shortages. And instead of focusing on bringing back manufacturing so we can be sort of self-dependent here in the U.S. without being dependent on other countries making the bulk of the goods and merchandise, instead of that, they're going to say, okay, we just need to send out more checks. In the meantime, corporations are going to see higher taxes here in the U.S., further incentivizing them to stay offshore or not bring back the jobs to the United States. Right? So the problems are not being addressed and definitely not being solved. It's more just papering over the problem. And we mean paper by money printing and sending out more stimulus checks instead of trying to control the rising prices and the inflationary environment that the money printers have actually created. Right? And it's not just the money printers. Of course, corporate taxes are something that's one of the reasons why you don't see many manufacturing plants here in the U.S. any longer. But even as the U.S. is the second largest producer of chips in the world, we still have these skyrocketing prices and shortages. So we're not equipped to manufacture as many chips as are in demand. But the United States people, for the most part, are really good at consuming, going out and spending money, getting free checks, you know, from the money printers and going out and spending it as fast as they can in many cases. A lot of this money is being speculated into the markets, into other assets, including digital assets. And instead of working, a lot of people just want to sit back, push a few buttons and make a lot of money, you know, buying the latest digital asset. And a lot of people are choosing not to work. Let's talk about the labor shortage next. And this is out of the Bureau of Labor Statistics. And we see the lower entry-level jobs, minimum wage. You see the tan colored line right here compared to the black line. The tan is what people are making on unemployment in that income level there. They're making a lot more in unemployment when you have the enhanced unemployment benefits combined with basic unemployment benefits. Who's going to go work for minimum wage when you can make more? Next level up, dishwashers, hotel clerks, even preschool teachers are making more on unemployment. So ask yourself, are those people going to be really looking for jobs when they're going to be making less and working a 40-hour, sometimes stressful, strenuous 40-hour week? Even truck drivers, it's very close. You're almost making as much in unemployment as you would actually working and driving 40-something hours a week or more, driving a truck down the road. Dental assistants, making a little bit more working versus unemployed. And then you get to the medium wage. The median is about $3, actually $2 and some change higher compared to just sitting back and collecting unemployment. All right, so what's going to happen is businesses are going to have to offer higher pay to attract people, to motivate people away from just sitting and collecting unemployment. And what's going to happen? Are those businesses just going to eat the cost? No, they're probably going to raise prices. So get ready, folks. It's starting to get nasty, and looks like it's going to get a lot worse. I'm not sure if anything's going to reverse this, but we'll have to keep an eye on it for you. Thanks for watching this report here today. Hope everybody's doing well. Stay well, stay safe. As always, stay prepared. Until next time, bye for now. Peace.